Hello Teamcenter users, need love so you can update live? I'm Herbert from Huerto Digital Solutions. This video gives you simple steps to build Dynamic LOV in Teamcenter. Like and let's go!
Hey everyone, welcome to our Teamcenter tutorial. Today, we're diving into creating dynamic LOVs. Let's get started by opening the BMIDE and heading to the Dynamic LOVs section. We'll create a new dynamic LOV called Material DLOV, which will store the different types of materials a wheel can have. Go to Dynamic LOV, New Dynamic LOV, name it HDS4 Material DLOV, and define the types of materials. What's the difference between a dynamic LOV, batch LOV, and classic LOV? Batch LOVs and classic LOVs use predefined values. Batch LOVs pull from an XML file and classic LOVs from the template file. A dynamic LOV, however, retrieves its values via a query, returning results dynamically when called. Set the type as List of Values Dynamic, and for query type, select FND0 Admin LOV Value. We're using this approach because, typically, a dynamic LOV requires creating and deploying a form for users to input values. Instead, we'll use a practical object, FND0 Admin LOV Value, to simplify the process without creating a new form. Click OK. In the query, add a condition. Check if the FND0 LOV category equals material. Set the LOV value attribute to FND0 LOV value, the description to FND0 LOV underscore description, and leave the filter attribute as is. Test the query with the user ID InfoDBA. Initially, there are no results. Open the Teamcenter Rich client, create a new object under New Other Administrative List of Values, and name it Aluminum to define a wheel's material. Set the value as Aluminum, the description as Aluminum, and the category as Material. Now, retest the query in BMIDE with the same credentials. The aluminum value should appear. This method allows administrators to add material types directly via the interface, avoiding command line changes, XML edits, or template deployment. When a user creates a new wheel revision, the dynamic LOV queries all administrator-defined values, offering a significant shortcut compared to the other approaches. Add more values via the Rich client, then test again in BMIDE to confirm they appear. Click Finish to complete the setup. Return to the Wheel Revision section and create a new property called Material. This time, we'll attach the LOV differently. Instead of using the LOV Attaches window, go to the Dynamic LOV section, scroll to the LOV Attaches section, and attach the property. Search for HDS4 Wheel Revision. Select the HDS4 material property and attach it. It should now appear in the properties list. Now let's deploy our changes to make the dynamic LOV live in Teamcenter. In BMIDE, generate the software package by selecting Generate Software Package. This bundles all your updates, including our HDS4 Material DLOV. Next, open the Environment Manager. If you're new to this, the Environment Manager is where you push changes to your Team Center environment. Select the latest contribution, check the timestamp to ensure it's the one we just created, and click Deploy. Wait for the confirmation that the deployment is successful. This step is critical, so double-check your selections to avoid errors. Once deployed, it's time to test everything in Teamcenter. Launch the rich client and log in as a test user. Unlike the InfoDBA user with full admin rights, this test user has limited permissions, mimicking a typical end user like an engineer or designer. Now, create a new item. Select New Item, choose Wheel, and enter the description. This is the latest version of the wheel. Click Next to fill in the properties. Set the date to the 26th of March. Choose the color yellow from the batch LOV values. Set the inner diameter to 25, the outer diameter to 30, and pick an intended use from the original batch LOV options. For the long description, type. This is a detailed description of the wheel. Finally, for the material, our Dynamic LOV, select aluminum from the dropdown. Take a moment to review the form. Everything should align with the values we set up. Now, create the item. You'll see the new wheel item in Teamcenter, with all properties correctly populated, confirming our Dynamic LOV works as intended. The changes we made in BMIDE are now fully integrated into the rich client. Pretty powerful, right? That wraps up our tutorial on creating dynamic LOVs in Teamcenter. If you found this helpful, give us a thumbs up, subscribe for more Teamcenter tips, and let us know in the comments if you want a deep dive into dynamic LOVs or other features. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.